In this video, I will share with you how to get a great sounding electric guitar mix when using a multi-mic guitar recording. Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. These four electric guitar tracks are part of a mixing project I was sent to mix. The four tracks are four different microphones and four speakers of the same speaker cabinet. These are the tracks and how they sound in solo. And if you play them together, it will sound like this. As you can hear, this sounds gritty and very high mid-range boosted. These four microphones, like this, work more against each other than together to create a great sound. There are a few things you can do, like picking the best sounding microphone and ditching the rest. Or do what I have done with these tracks and let me show you. You need to dive in the tracks and check if they are phase coherent. This basically means, in this case, that the sound arrives at all mix at the same time. And if there's a small difference, you can either have a dip or a boost in certain frequencies. So if you flip the phase between tracks, it can already improve the sound. Sometimes it's enough, but often it's not, like with these tracks. Now you could hear the before and after in the beginning. Let's play it again. And you could hear the huge difference. The next step will get you a lot closer to that sound. You'll see that the waveforms don't line up. There always will be differences with different mics and different speakers. But here you can see that where the waveforms go up and down, the tracks are not aligned. Slightly different microphone positions or even the placement of the capsule inside the microphone can cause slight different timings. Even a difference of half a centimeter will cause a visible delay and an audible phase change when you use two tracks or more. So we need to line those up. Let's take one track as your, let's call it master track, and align the rest to that one. While moving the tracks, listen to the best sound between the two tracks. Now we have aligned them all. And it sounds like this together. And before time alignment, it sounded like this. Now, don't overdo this and keep listening to what sounds best. Even when it's not perfectly lined up, it can still sound the best due to the slight frequency cancellation and frequency boosts. Listen to when it sounds best. Now I'm not totally happy yet. There's a strong mid-upper presence, a grit. This happens with close mic recording guitar amps a lot. If I dip it on the group bus, I can reduce this already. But I prefer to dive in these separate tracks and do the EQ dips per speaker and microphone. Using EQ can change the phase response, so keep checking and listening while you do it. Now it went from this to this. And this is how we started out. And this is how we ended up. From here you can add EQ to shape and tweak the guitar sound to fit in a complete mix. And you made sure you have a great basis for a great guitar sound. Going through the tracks like I showed you will save you a lot of headaches and fighting in a mix. And if you want to learn more about mixing, check out the video displayed on screen right now. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Thank you for watching and I will see you in the next one. Bye!